Now, when Apple introduced macOS Sonoma, there was some hope that they would also introduce a dedicated passwords app so you could easily access or view all of your passwords, your iCloud passwords, through this app. Well, that didn't happen. We still need to dig through our system settings to view all of our passwords. Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can build that dedicated password app. We don't have to wait for Apple to create that app for us. We can do it ourselves. And it's pretty simple. This is all done through the Shortcuts app. If you've been following my videos, you may have seen my videos on how you can do this for the iPad and the iPhone. I have created videos for how you can do this for both of those devices as well. I'll have links to those in the description. Let's take a look at how we can build a dedicated passwords app for our Mac. Let's go over to my Mac. Now, as I mentioned, the way that this works is this is all done through the Shortcuts app. So I'm going to go to my Applications folder and open up the Shortcuts app. So I'm going to open up a new Finder window, and then we go over to Applications, and what you're going to see here is Shortcuts. Shortcuts is an app that is developed by Apple, and it allows you to build shortcuts. And in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to build a shortcut to view our passwords. This replaced AppleScript. So let's go ahead and double click on this. I'm going to hide this Finder window in the back here. And now I'm looking at my shortcuts. So these are all of my different shortcuts here. Again, if you're familiar with AppleScript, this would be all of my different AppleScripts. So what I need to do is I need to create a new shortcut. This shortcut is going to show my passwords. So I click on the plus here. And now what I need to do is I need to add an action. Well, what is the action? Well, the action is show my passwords. So I go over to the right here and I search for that action. So I type in here passwords. And you're going to see show passwords. I double click on it and it adds it to my shortcut. So that's the only step that we're going to add to this shortcut. We can actually run this shortcut. Let's make sure that this works. To make sure it works, what we do is we click on the play button here. And when I do, it's going to show me my password. So let's go ahead and click on it. I use my fingerprint ID, and there's my passwords. So we know that this shortcut works. Now the next thing that I want to do is I want to name it, rename it. I want to add a nice icon for it, and then I want to add it to my dock. So let's first rename it. To rename it, what we do is we just go up to where it says show passwords. That's the current name. I'm just going to click in here, and I'm just going to call it passwords. That's what I would like to have it named as. So I type in here passwords, hit return. So now I've just renamed it. First step done. Next step, we need to create a new icon. I don't want to have this icon here. I would like to have a gray icon so it matches my system settings and maybe put a key on there. To do that, what we do is we just click on this and then you're going to see we can change the color. I'm going to go with this gray here. And I can search for a symbol. So let's go with key. And I have key here. Click on it. And now we can see we have my new name and we have my nice icon. The last step is to add this to my dock. So then I have easy access to it. To do that, what we do is we just go up under File. And under File, you're going to see Add to Dock. Let's go ahead and select it. And now we can see we have this in my dock. That's basically all we have to do. Let's go ahead and quit out of shortcuts. I'm done with this now. I've built my shortcut. I want to view my passwords. Well, instead of going to my system settings underneath the Apple menu, all I need to do is just click on this, use my fingerprint ID here, and there's my passwords. So I didn't need to go into system settings, go and find passwords, click on passwords. All I needed to do was just click on this icon here, and when I do, as long as I use the fingerprint ID, it just opens right up to my passwords. And here's a little bonus. I mentioned this with the video on the iPad and the iPhone. Being that this is built with shortcuts, shortcuts works across all your different devices. So this shortcut is also going to be on your iPad and your iPhone. And then from there, what you're able to do is add it to your home screen. So you only have to build it once, and then on each device, go and add it to your home screen. If you want to learn more about that, take a look at those links in the video again, or in the description again. So that is how we can build an application to view all of our different passwords on the Mac. Again, this is all done through the Shortcuts app.